Assalamu alaikum, dear students. My name is Hasnain Shabir. I am your instructor for the course of Introduction to Political Science, which we are starting today. Political science is a fascinating course. It covers global politics, international relations, and system of comparative governments, and history as well as society. In other words, this course is about me, you, and all of us. So very first we have definition and scope of political science. A great thinker, Aristotle, defined political science as the study of the state. Keep in mind, the word political science have been derived from the Greek word polis, which means city-state. Dear students, please subscribe this channel for further information. In today's discussion, as I already told you, we will be covering definition and scope of political science. Must know down this definition. Let's move towards scope of political science. The scope of political science implies its jurisdiction or subject matter. Political science is a very wide and comprehensive subject. We may make an attempt to define the scope of political science, which includes, here I will share different aspect with you. Very first is study of the state and government. Political science primarily studies the problems of the state and government. The state is defined as a group of people organized for law within definite territory. And note down here a very important information about state. State has four elements: population, territory, government, and sovereignty. And each of these elements is compulsory. So absence of any one of these means to say no state can prevail. Here I quote fourth element, that was sovereignty. Sovereignty has two types: internal sovereignty and external sovereignty. Next we have study of political theory. Political theory is a major branch of political science. On the basis of the political ideas or thoughts of political thinkers, political theory formulates definitions or concepts like democracy, liberty, equality, grounds of political obligation. A student of political science must start his or her lesson with political theory. It also includes the study of political philosophy. I would request you to again please note down all these outlines for your better understanding, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Next we have a study of political institutions. The field of political science is rather vast. It includes the study of political institutions. This covers a study of constitutions and comparative government, explains their merits and demerits, their structure and working, and arrives at different conclusions on comparative basis. Besides, the study of political administration and local government may be included in this area. One more example I would like to share with you. This course of Introduction to Political Science is very much important for CSS point of view, for the students of Federal Public Service Commission, for the students of Punjab Public Service Commission. Next, we have a study of political dynamics. The study of political dynamics has become significant in the 20th century. It means the current forces at work. It means the current forces at work in government and politics. It covers a wide range and includes the study of political parties, public opinion, pressure groups, lobbies. A scientific study of the working of these political dynamics helps to explain the political behavior of individual and different groups, because individuals and different groups both are having significant importance in the study of political science. The study in this field is also related to the study of adjustment of the individual and the state. You must know that the scope of political science also includes a study of the nature of relationship between the individual and the state. It examines how man should adjust himself with society, because man is the root of politics. The process of adjustment of men with the society is an important aspect of political science. In this subject, we also discuss comparison of different form of governments, different system of governments of the world. We have different systems in different countries. But next we have a study of international relations and international law. While discussing the scope of political science, political science includes a study of international relations, which has become significant since the first quarter of the 20th century. It covers a wide range and includes diplomacy, international politics, international law, international organizations like the United Nations. United Nations was introduced in 1945, as I told you earlier, that this was started during the first quarter of the 20th century, means to say right after the World War I. So the World War I was ended in 1918, and after that the League of Nations was started. Now let's come to the conclusion. The content which I shared with you show the wide range of subjects that come under the fold of political science. Broadly speaking, political science contains the topics dealing with the empirical facts and philosophical values. Thank you, dear students, for viewing this presentation. Subscribe, like, share, and comment. In case of any query, the house is open for you. You can comment at here, or you can contact with us at hasnanshabir44@gmail.com. Allah Nigeban.